Most students know L'Hôpital's rule, that powerful tool we use to evaluate tricky limits like 0 divided by 0. But here's a twist. The man it's named after might not have discovered it. Today we dive into a story of genius, generosity, and a secret contract. Meet Guillaume de L'Hôpital, a French nobleman with a passion for math. After retiring from a military career due to vision problems, he devoted himself to studying the new and exciting subject of calculus. In the early 1690s, he crossed paths with a 24-year-old Swiss prodigy, Johann Bernoulli. Bernoulli was a rising star of the calculus world, sharp, creative, and already pushing the boundaries of mathematics. The two struck an unusual deal. Bernoulli would teach L'Hôpital privately, share his latest discoveries, and in return, L'Hôpital would pay him a generous stipend. In 1694, their collaboration became official. L'Hôpital agreed to pay 300 livres a year, a considerable sum, in exchange for exclusive rights to Bernoulli's discoveries. The deal even said Bernoulli should not share his work with anyone else. 2 years later, in 1696, L'Hôpital published Analyse des Infiniment Petits, the first textbook on differential calculus. It was an instant success, clear, elegant, and packed with powerful ideas. One of them? A technique for resolving limits like 0 over 0, now known as L'Hôpital's rule. But guess who actually came up with it? That's right. Bernoulli had taught the rule in his lessons. It was his discovery, but you wouldn't know that from the book. At first, Bernoulli kept quiet. After all, he had agreed to the deal. But as L'Hôpital gained more and more credit for ideas that weren't his, Bernoulli grew resentful. When L'Hôpital died in 1704, Bernoulli finally spoke out. He revealed their contract and claimed that much of the famous textbook, including L'Hôpital's rule, came from his own work. People were skeptical. Some thought Bernoulli was exaggerating. After all, the rule had become synonymous with L'Hôpital. Then in 1921, historians made an amazing discovery. Bernoulli's original lecture notes from the 1690s. And guess what? They matched L'Hôpital's book, word for word in places. That confirmed it. Johann Bernoulli was the true originator of L'Hôpital's rule. He didn't just teach it, he discovered it. So, should we stop calling it L'Hôpital's rule? Maybe. But this story reminds us of something bigger, how collaboration, mentorship, and sometimes even strange agreements shape the history of mathematics. Behind every formula is a story, and now you know this one.